Hey guys, Level Cap here, and today in gaming, Battlefield 2042 might feature maps and content from past titles. The Halo Master Chief Collection might be getting 60-player servers, AMD drops support for older GPUs, and much more. Battlefield leaker Tom Henderson claims the third mode for Battlefield 2042 being developed by DICE LA will serve as a Battlefield hub. He says that it'll offer remasters of classic maps from across the franchise's history and throws all the weapons and vehicles from past games together in one massive sandbox experience. The maps will primarily support up to 64 players, though some will offer 2042's headline feature of 128 players. Henderson says his sources describe the mode as a casual experience designed to be fun and the ultimate sandbox experience instead of a competitive mode. DICE haven't confirmed anything about this mode other than it will not be a battle royale. The official description of it reads, "Created as a love letter to our core fans, a new way to play Battlefield is coming. Discover unexpected battles and enter the wide universe of Battlefield with this experience." Henderson says unlike past leaks, his sources couldn't provide credible evidence that Battlefield Hub is real. He also says Hazard Zone will be a free-to-play mode that's similar to Escape from Tarkov. Again, DICE haven't dished any details about Hazard Zone other than saying it's a squad-based high-stakes experience and also not a battle royale. In more concrete Battlefield news, EA uploaded a build of Battlefield 2042 on the PlayStation Network. The game is 20GB and uses the development codename 4-2042. MP first confirmed that text in the file shows that it's a Battlefield game. It sounds like this build is an alpha version and might be the one DICE are offering to Battlefield veterans during a white box testing session sometime next month. What lends credibility to MP1's findings is that EA also added an alpha version of Dragon Age 4 to the PlayStation Store. Finally, EA announced the start time for EA Play Live on June 22nd. The event kicks off at 10 a.m. Pacific time. They'll reveal more info about Battlefield 2042 during the presentation, including Hazard Zone, DICE LA's mode, the NDA white box test, early access beta, and open beta. The Halo Master Chief Collection might be getting 60-player battles. A producer working on the game said that the team is investigating support for up to 40 or even 60 players. That would be a massive leap from the Master Chief Collection's biggest official mode, 8v8 Big Team Battle. And while 60-player modes seem like a bit of a stretch when compared to previous Halo game modes, it should be doable on modern tech, and there's already Battle Royale mods for the Master Chief Collection. And even if 60 players aren't supported on official servers, giving modders the ability to host that many players in custom modes would be a huge deal. AMD are dropping driver support for older GPUs. NVIDIA recently announced that they're doing the same thing for their GTX 600 series GPUs. AMD are ending support for their RX 300 series and pre-Ryzen APUs. That doesn't mean that they'll stop working today, but it could become a problem down the line as new games come out that require driver optimization and compatibility updates. That said, the RX 300 series is 6 years old. It's not like they're dropping support for cutting-edge hardware. Microsoft are rolling out a big update for the xCloud game streaming service. They're transitioning the service's hardware to Xbox Series X servers. xCloud users can now play Rainbow Six Siege at 120 FPS thanks to the upgrade, and more games will follow as the new hardware is deployed. Oculus recently announced a new program that displays ads in VR headsets, and the reaction has been quite negative. Resolution Games was the first developer that signed up to test the ad system, and they quickly backed out because of the feedback from players. The game was review bombed because of the ads, and it's not entirely without cause. Blastin is a paid title. Normally, you might expect these sorts of advertisements in free-to-play games. This is certainly a concern for becoming the norm to have ads in paid games on a VR headset. Especially with the ads broadcasting through the headset itself, it's sort of like if a monitor company started including pop-up ads on their displays. And while that is more common in the realm of smart TVs, it's still a new frontier for PC gaming. Overwatch players aren't too thrilled about the crossplay beta that just went live. The beta has disabled region-based matchmaking for solo players. Previously, players could pick a specific region to matchmake for. Now, all players are lumped into one universal option with no way of opting out. Players are reporting being placed in out-of-region servers regularly with a ping of 100 milliseconds or higher. Hopefully, Blizzard are working on re-implementing region selection. A bug in the latest update for Marvel's Avengers could potentially leak your IP address. The update causes your IP address to be displayed on screen if you're playing on the PlayStation 5. If you stream yourself playing the game or upload screenshots, you could easily reveal your IP address, which makes you a big target for malicious activity like DDoS attacks and doxing. A hotfix is rolling out now for PlayStation 5 players that should resolve the issue. Until you can confirm you have the hotfix installed, avoid broadcasting yourself playing that game. Microsoft's no questions asked refund policy for Cyberpunk 2077 digital copies ends on July 6th. The policy was put in place to deal with the massive wave of refunds surrounding the game's launch. It got so bad, Sony pulled the game from sale days after launch and only just relisted it this week. Xbox digital sales are typically considered final, and Microsoft won't offer an automatic refund unless your country's laws require it. The iconic Nintendo 64 turned 25 today, which is crazy to think because that was one of my favorite consoles growing up, and man, am I getting old. And the legacy of the N64 extends way beyond Nintendo's sphere of influence. GoldenEye 64 laid the groundwork for console FPS games, and the console itself helped cement the prevalence of 3D games following the PlayStation 1's success. And of course, it was a massive success for Nintendo, thanks to games like Super Mario 64 and Zelda Ocarina of Time. It's crazy to think that so much of what's popular in gaming today had big roots with the N64. Co-op shooter Aliens Fireteam Elite has a release date. It blends the linear survival gameplay of Left 4 Dead with the world and story of the Alien film franchise. Early previews of the game have been very positive. Before we get to our final story today, make sure you're subscribed to catch all the breaking Battlefield 2040 news as it develops. EA Play might not be until next month, but we'll be covering any new info about the game between now and then. Don't miss out. Valve finally released an update for Team Fortress 2 that attempts to deal with the game being overrun by cheating bots. The source code for the game leaked some time ago, leading to a massive influx of hacks and cheats targeted at the game's official servers. Since then, the community has taken it upon itself to host custom servers that block cheaters. It's gotten so bad that those community servers have their own custom bots that actively target cheating bots. Team Fortress 2 was in a dire state despite the community's efforts to save it from cheaters. Valve's update includes some quality of life improvements like preventing players from changing their names to avoid bans, and security fixes that seem to have eliminated the cheating bots. Hopefully these fixes are permanent. And that wraps it up for Today in Gaming. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time. This is Level Cap, signing off.